In this educating video, we will show how to run a basic signal integrity analysis for selected NAT using HyperLynx software. After opening the board, first of all you need to check the stack up. Make sure signal and planes layers were assigned correctly. Check the material thickness and their properties. Second, verify power supply nets. Run voltage value on pull-up or pull-down resistors will give incorrect results. Select the net you want to simulate. For easy navigation, use a net filter. Next, you need to check assigned modules. Verify termination resistor value, set output for driver and input for receivers. Some IBIS modules have options for buffer selection. Select the buffer you need for your design. If you don't know which buffer to select, evaluate them all and find one that shows the best results. You can open and edit IBIS model in the model viewer. Buffer modules available for selection are located under the field called Model Selector. Also, you can change pin mapping and differential pair assignment if needed. Enable lossy line and bias modeling options to include their effects in simulation. Run the interactive simulation. A digital oscilloscope will be opened. Select oscillator mode. Fill in the frequency you want to check. Probes can be placed either on a pin or die. We are ready to start the simulation. Signal waveforms on different probes will be shown on the screen. Use scale buttons to adjust waveforms for better view. You can turn on or off waveform on every integrated circuit. The most important is the receiver. It is possible to create an eye diagram for signal quality evaluation. Configure eye diagram settings. Select bit pattern from existing presets or create your own. Add jitter if you need to take it into account. Here you can also select an eye mask or create new for your requirements. Put probes on receivers and start the simulation. Inspect eye diagram for compliance with the standard. HyperLynx board sim intended for post layout simulations and working with layout data, which cannot be edited, although minor modifications can be performed to check what-if scenarios. Now we will conduct a simulation for the DDR signal with the signal integrity problem and will try to solve it by using the feature Quick Termination. We will run the simulation with the same settings as for the previous NAT. The signal is non-monotonic at one of the receiver's die. See the green waveform. Run eye diagram simulation. The eye diagram looks not good enough for both receivers. It also shows that the signal has overshoot and ringing. Run termination wizard to see NAT statistics. The probable reason for the signal integrity issue is the absence of a termination resistor in flyby topology. We can check it by adding termination near the last DDR chip as it is done for the rest address signals without layout modification. A parallel DC resistor will be added to the simulation. Rerun the simulation. Both signal waveform and eye diagram look good now.